the times now.
Uganda decides.
In Elegu, the afternoon brings three things: a very hot sun, dust, and heavy trucks. Elegu sits on Uganda's border with the world's youngest country, South Sudan. Many call this town Nimule. Trade in currency is one of the most basic businesses here. In the afternoon, heavy trucks carrying everything from cement to vegetables and from fuel to passengers eat up almost half of Elegu's dirt road, waiting for clearance to cross the border. When they cross the border, a repeat of the clearance routine happens. Checks, forms, and stamps alike. A lack of a one-stop border center means the movement of people and goods from Uganda to South Sudan and vice versa is a slow, painstaking process. So this is the Elegu border point in AMURU district. To my right is South Sudanese territory, and to my left is Ugandan territory. And because of that, the customs and immigration departments of both countries function independently. Now, what a one-stop center would do is to have the immigration and customs departments of Uganda and South Sudan housed in a single building, in a single office, thereby saving time and coordination costs. I caught up with Noah, Arafat and Rashid, truck drivers from Uganda. They regularly cross the border into South Sudan and back into Uganda, and they dread the long immigration and customs procedures. There's a general consensus here that things are better in Uganda. The customs and immigration offices are located next to each other and are powered 24/7 by a generator. In South Sudan, months of lawlessness and conflict and mismanagement mean procedures are often abused and exposed to corruption. And that has Noah and his colleagues furious. In one of the fuel tankers waiting for clearance, I met Michael, a tanman. They have driven all the way from Eldoret, Kenya. Nimule, he tells me, is a place where a lot of time is lost. But things are about to change for Elegu. A one-stop border center is planned here. The center, one of the measures by the East African Community to promote trade and integration, will open in 2 years. Until then, Elegu will continue living the Stone Age times, stamping its notoriety as a waster of time and money. Ronald Kato, reporting for TNR.
The times now. Uganda decides.